Is your boat so smart it's fooling you? You know, modern powerboats are just jam-packed with tech. Hey there, people, I'm Lenny Rudow for BoatUS, and we're gonna talk about three digital disasters that you need to look out for. Number one is right here, the fuel gauge. Today's digital fuel gauges are much better than the notoriously inaccurate fuel gauges on boats of the past. But you sure want to make sure that thing doesn't tell you you have fuel when you don't, or you'll end up calling for a tow from BoatUS. You do have your membership up to date, right? Here's the scoop, people. Those digital gauges, they need to be calibrated. And the problem is a lot of boat builders don't calibrate the fuel gauge before they deliver the boat. Your dealer may or may not. So when you take delivery of a new boat, if you don't know for darn sure that thing's been calibrated properly, it may show you half a tank when in fact you got no fuel. Google up your owner's manual to find out the specific way you calibrate your gauge. Once you do so, you might find that it works really well. Here's our second digital disaster, people. Look at this fish finder. It tells me there's 9.5 feet of water under the boat, when in fact, there's more like 8 feet of water under the boat. On this boat, that's not a huge difference, unless you're in 2 or 3 feet of water, but for a lot of boats, that may mean the difference between cruising along and running aground, and then having to call your friendly neighborhood TowBoatUS captain. The problem is that the transducer at the back of your boat probably is not at the lowest point on the hull. In fact, it almost surely isn't. So you need to tell the machine this. You need to go into the settings, which will be different depending on what type of machine you have. You'll have to look this up in the owner's manual and figure out how to tell it just how far under the boat that transducer is. Digital disaster number three, well, that's right here, the VHF. And this, people, is the most important one to look out for of all. All VHFs built after 1999 have what's called digital selective calling, or DSC. That means if you press the emergency button, the Coast Guard will get your position as well as your transmission automatically. Critically important, right? But it only works if you've programmed in your MMSI number. Now, your VHF also needs GPS data. Many modern units have GPS built right in, as this one does. In case yours is old enough that it doesn't, you will need to interface it with your GPS or chart plotter, which is simple. It's a matter of putting two wires together. Extra special bonus, people. If you're a BoatUS member, you get that MMSI number for free. Just go to BoatUS.com/MMSI. And programming it in takes all of 30 seconds. Folks, I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to click below and subscribe. And check out BoatUS.com. You can find lots of articles and videos there on how to set up your VHF so that it's DSC active. And you know, folks, all these digital dilemmas can be problematic, but this one in particular with your VHF, that could save your life.